the Children's TV Workshop presents Sesame Street Show 480, produced in color with teletype, New York.
Jugando a los jacks. Mira lo que me hallé.
Mira qué lindo.
Estaba aquí en la calle.
Oh, God, he's beautiful.
Qué bonito, ¿verdad?
Oh, look who's here. Ya llegaron.
Oh, hola, ¿qué tal?
Hola, ¿cómo está? We've been waiting for you. Well, look at this pretty little cat. Oh. You know, I wonder what it would be like to be as small as that kitten. Or maybe even smaller. Maybe as small as this Jack. Let's think about it and try to imagine what that would be like, okay? Let's all think about that.
Oh, wow. Look how small I am. Look how big everything else is. Why, look how big Luis looks. Look at that. Why, I'm almost as small as these jacks here. Wow, that's really weird. It really is strange being this small. Look at the size of that cat. Wow, it looks like a dinosaur. Hey, I hope he doesn't think that I'm a little bug or a mouse or something and he gets hungry. As a matter of fact, I think I'm gonna get out of here before he thinks that. I'm gonna jump right off this ledge. I can't jump down. That's too far. Oh, I don't know what to do. I don't have a rope or a ladder, and I don't like being near that cat because he might think I'm a mouse or something. What should I do? Huh? Oh, what? Stop imagining that I'm so tiny? Right, that's what I'll do. Oh, I don't know why I didn't think of it. That's a great idea. I'll just stop imagining that I'm so tiny. That was close.
Hey, Maria, where were you? You looked like you were a million miles away.
Oh, I was just off somewhere in my imagination. Oh, it's just a little kitten, isn't it?
Just a little kitten, right?
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
I've thought a lot about a thought. I've thought about thinking. Thought about it a lot. I've thought some more, and do you know what? I think I've thought a thought. This thought is very small. How many small things can you think of? How about a flea? an ant, a grain of sand, or a pin. A ladybug is small, so is a pebble, and a speck of dust is very small. A blade of grass, or a gumdrop. Let's see, what else is small?
How about a sea monster?
You're not small, you're big.
I am too small. My daddy's big.
Danger! Danger!
One and one are two. Two and one are three. Three and one are four. Four and one are five. One and one are two. Two and one are three. Three and one are four. Four and one are five. Five. One from five is four. One from four is three. One from three is two. One from two is one. One from five is four. One from four is three. One from three is two. One from two is one.
Bunch of grouts are standing in line outside. What's going on here?
Yeah, well, I'm glad they're here because, you see, I'm taking a few days off from Sesame Street. Gotta go someplace else, so I'm gonna have somebody replace me.
But what are you doing?
Never mind, I'm gonna have the first one come in now. Hey, first grouch tryout, come on in. This is gonna be interesting. Hey.
Oh, why howdy, Brother Grouch. Say, is this here the grouch tryouts?
Yeah, and I got a test for you to see if you'd make a good enough grouch.
Oh, why, shucks, I'm a great grouch. What's the test?
Well, let's see here. Now, look. Now, say somebody gives you a flower, see?
Yeah.
Somebody's always doing something nice like that. Now, if you were the grouch on Sesame Street, what would you do with this?
Why, you see, I don't much like flowers because I'm a grouch.
Good.
So I'd just take this here flower and I'd pull out like that. And then I'd probably, I don't know, throw it in a wastebasket, something like
that. What? Wait, give me that flower.
Huh?
That's not grouchy at all.
No?
Why, if you were the grouch on Sesame Street, you'd take that flower, you'd pull it out, and you'd throw the dirt over the store.
Wait a minute, man.
On the floor?
Got it all over the counter.
And then you'd say, who gave me this dumb flower? I hate flowers. And you'd yell at them. Oh! Send in the next grouch.
Hey, you guys need a good grouch?
Yeah, okay. Here's your grouch test.
Yeah?
Suppose I gave you this old dirty shirt. It's all torn stuff, see? Now, if you're the grouch on Sesame Street, what would you do with this shirt?
Hey, that's one beautiful shirt. I'd wear that shirt to the opera. That's what I'd do. Here, let me try that shirt on. That's a pretty...
Stop. Give me that shirt.
Huh?
That's not grouchy enough at all.
Oh?
Yeah, if you were a real grouch, you'd say, hey, that shirt's old and torn, but not torn enough. So you'd rip it here, see? But then you wouldn't want to wear it. You'd want to hang it on the living room wall. No good. Oh.
Okay, if you ever get to Denver, don't bother to look me up.
Yeah, well, you can count on that, fella. Send in the next grouch.
Hey, will you get this show on the road? I've been waiting all day.
Hey, I like this one. Look, pal, here's a bunch of newspapers. Say somebody gives you these old newspapers, eh?
Oh, yeah?
What would you do with them if you were the grouch on Sesame Street?
Well, I love old newspapers. Yeah. First, I'd tear them up into shreds
like that.
And then I'd throw some of them on the floor
Good. Yeah.
And then the rest of them, I'd take for a salad. And the rest of them, I'd throw at people like that.
Hey. Yeah, that's great. Yeah. Great, good. You are the one. You're the grouchiest one of all. Listen, pal, I like your style. If you want the job of assistant grouch on Sesame Street, it is yours.
Oh, Oscar, thanks. Thanks so much. Oh, I'm so excited. Gee, you're wonderful. Oh, what a thing to make me the assistant on Sesame Street. Assistant grouch. Oh, thanks, Oscar. That's wonderful. I'm so happy.
Wait a minute.
I'm really happy.
Wait.
Oh, thanks.
Hold that. What kind of a grouch are you? No grouch says thanks. Out! Scram!
You mean I'm
no job! Boy, forget it! Boy, did he blow it with that thanks.
Well, that's all of them, Oscar.
Yeah, I guess it's no use. If you want a job done right, you gotta stay and do it yourself. It's always up to me to make Sesame Street grouchy.
T is for toys, and tractor, and trains, and teacher, and tiger, and turtles with brains.
6 times 7 is 42, and Mechanicsburg is a city in Pennsylvania.
T is also for tickle, and table, and tops, and Texas, and teeth. Why, T never stops.
I'm going to paint a 10. Now let's see, where can I paint a 10? Aha! Sorry. my 10. My 10's gone.
How would you like to meet some people around the neighborhood today? All right.
Oh, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, in your neighborhood. Say, who are the people in your neighborhood? The people that you meet each day.
Hi there, mister. How are you?
Hi. Hey, it's a nifty-looking sweater you got there.
Thanks very much.
You got a little spot in the front, though.
Oh, how'd you notice that?
It's my job to notice. See these clothes?
Yep.
Well, I clean them up, I bag them up, hang them up, and ship them out.
Oh, you must be a...
I'm a cleaner.
Tell me about it.
All right, I'll tell you about it. Oh, a cleaner is a man who knows how to clean and press your finest clothes. I'll take a jacket, suit, or vest, and clean it so you look your best.
'Cause a cleaner is a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in
your neighborhood. Oh, a cleaner is a person in your neighborhood.
A person that you meet each day.
I'll see you a little
later. I got work to do.
All right. Oh, now, could you give me a clue as to who you are?
I don't use clue, I use glue.
Oh, you use glue. And you use a hammer and
right.
Nails,
yeah.
And you're fixing a little shoe.
Uh-huh.
You must be the shoemaker.
You're right, I am.
Tell me about it.
Okay. Oh, the shoemaker's always there to take care of the shoes you wear. With my hammer and my nails and glue, I'll fix your shoes as good as new.
'Cause a shoemaker's a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in your neighborhood.
And a cleaner is a person in your neighborhood.
Well, they're the people that you meet.
When you're walking down the street, they're the people that you meet each day.
Ten. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 tiny turtles on the telephone, talking with the grocery men. We would like some lettuce. Will you send us 10 heads, please? And 10 sweet potatoes and 10 rutabagas with the dimples on their knees. And send us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 artichokes. 10 eggplants, over easy. That's one of our little jokes. 10 leafy, leafy collard greens, and please make sure they're washed. Light up our eyes, brighten our lives with 10 banana squash. We'll eat 10 cans of black-eyed peas. They give you good, strong muscles. 10 of those tasty sprouts, the ones that they call Brussels. We'd also like 10 mangoes. They're the favorite of our sister Gert. And one last thing, please do include 10 apples for dessert.
10.
Hi, this is Grover. Yeah, and today I'm going to talk to you about heavy and light. Yeah, okay, this is a barbell I have in front of me right here, and this barbell is heavy. Now, I will show you how heavy it is. I will try and lift it. Here we go. Once more. Oh, it is heavier than I thought. Try once more. Oh, this barbell is heavy! Well, I think that is enough about heavy today, huh? Let us now talk about light, all right? Now, come with me. See over here, this feather? Now, feathers are light, and this feather is light. Here, I will pick it up and show you. See ya. I will pick up this feather. Wait a minute. Why can I not pick up this feather? This feather is supposed to be light. Why is it not light?
because this feather is attached to me, and I'm heavy.
I give up.
Maria. Maria, yeah, could you come down here and help us for a minute? You see, today we're going to talk about the difference between heavy and light. Now, Mr. Hooper is heavy. Maria, would you please pick up Mr. Hooper? Yes, you. Please pick up Mr. Hooper. Uh-huh. Yeah. See? Yeah, it's like I said, Mr. Hooper is heavy. Right. Now we will show you light. Maria, go pick up Luis. Maria. All right. See, Mr. Hooper was heavy. And look at that. Easy. Down, down gently. Oh, it was easy. Luis was light. No, it has nothing to do with strength. It has to do with heavy and light. You see? That's the difference between heavy and light. Thank you.
What's that?
It's just a line.
Just a line going up and down.
No, it's more than that.
Now it's a line with a triangle.
A flag.
And now it's a line with two triangles.
I know. It's an umbrella. I was wrong.
Three triangles?
What is that?
Now it has four triangles.
It's a kite.
That's what it is, all right.
Yes, it's a kite.
Uh-oh, something's happening to it.
It fell over.
And a piece fell out.
What is this?
I see.
It's a fish. So that's what it was.
Goldfish has two eyes, like me. But I wonder if he sees things the same way I do. Don't. I guess it might be fun to be a goldfish. But I'm glad I'm not in the water all the time.
Hi. When I was in kindergarten, Miss Johnson, my teacher, taught us the ABCs, and she had a funny-sounding voice. Let me show you how she sounded. She said, A, B, C, D, whee, E, F, G. Then she'd say, H, I, J, K. And everybody'd say, yay, Miss Johnson, don't stop. And then she'd say, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. And everybody say, yay, Miss Johnson. We liked her.
Hey, I'd like to talk to you about the letter T. It looks sort of like a little hook with a line across the top. Very useful letter. When you're hungry, there's tea, toast, taffy, tomatoes, and turkey. Now, if you want to talk about animals, you can talk about tadpoles, tigers, toads, and turtles. Lots of people have jobs that start with T. Like there's teachers, traffic cops, truck drivers, tailors, typists, and taxi drivers. Why, right on your own body, you have teeth, a tongue, toes. But best of all is how much fun you can have with tea. Why, you can tap dance and play tag, play with toys and travel on a train, tickle, talk. Or you can tootle a tune on a tuba. A terrific letter, the letter T.
T. Top.
Oh, hi. Hey, let's play a game, all right? Here we go. See if you can tell me which one of these goes here.
Here are some things that belong together. They're kind of the same. It's perfectly clear. One of these things belongs with the others. Which one goes in the space right here?
Huh? Can you guess? Let's take a look at this and see what these are. The big ones here, we have our big round circles, right? Now, over here, we have a circle, right? It's not as big as these, but it's a circle. And this one here is a big square, yeah. So which one do you think, which one of these two goes with these over here, huh? You say this one? The circle. Well, yeah, that's very good. You're right. You see, now, if you look at these real closely, you will see that all four of these, this one, and this one, are all round, like circles. That's very good. But take another look. Look at this. If you said that it was the square, then that's a right answer also. You know why? Take a good look. This is a big shape, isn't it? And so is this one and this one. And this is a big shape also, you see. Right, so by size, these are all the same. They're all big. And by shape, these are all the same because they're all round. See?
10, 9, 8. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell a smell, sniff a sniff, and take a breath. You can move your feet to walk, and you use your tongue to talk, but Your mouth and nose are waiting. Take a breath. Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell it, smell. Sniff it, sniff. Take a breath. You can move your teeth to chew, but your face is turning blue. Get some air inside of you. Just take a breath. You never think of breathing, though you do it all day long. You even have to breathe to sing this funny little song. You've got to take a breath before you try to blow a bubble. And if you stop your breathing, you got big, big trouble. So take a good deep breath. That's better. Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell a smell. Sniff a sniff and take a breath. There are many ways to play, but you're growing every day, and you need some ventilation. Take a breath. You got to do your breathing. Take a breath. Take a breath.
G. Train. G.
Y'all want to finish, Ernie? Huh?
Don't
Ernie?
Move. Oh, don't move, Bert.
Okay.
Almost got it here.
I want to see it, Ernie. I want to see
here
it.
We go. And it is finished.
Oh, boy. Let me see. Let me see.
Okay, Bert.
Okay.
Take a look at it here.
Okay.
How's that?
Oh, wow. That's great, Ernie. Hey, but, Ernie?
Yes?
It's not quite finished. I mean, it looks almost finished, but it's not quite finished.
Almost? Why, what do you mean, Bert? It looks exactly like you.
Ernie, part of the face is missing there. See?
Part of the face is missing?
Yeah.
Well, what do you mean, Bert?
Well, look at that
everything
face and then
there.
Look at my let's, face and see.
Well, let's see. It's got two eyes up there.
Yeah, and I have two eyes, too, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's got two ears.
Two ears. I have two ears.
You have two ears. It's got a mouth.
A mouth. I've got a mouth, too, yeah.
It's got eyebrows.
Yep, two eyebrows.
Yeah,
I mean, I have eyebrows, too. Yeah.
It's got a nose.
Oh,
Bert.
You forgot the nose.
I forgot the nose.
Right.
How could I do that? Well, don't worry, Bert. I'll just get some more clay
okay,
here.
I'll stand still here.
Oh, no.
What?
Why, Bert.
What?
I'm all out of clay.
Oh, no.
I don't have any more clay. What'll I do?
Oh, gee, I don't know, Ernie. It looks so nice except for the nose.
Well, Bert.
What?
I have an idea. Come here a second, Bert.
Oh, yeah? You going to tell me? What is it?
Yeah.
What is it?
Just come here.
Oh, tell me a secret?
Mm-hmm. Ah! Just there we go. Perfect.
I don't understand.
Kermit the Frog here, and today I have a new and special game for you. It's called One of These Things Belongs with the Others. You know that game? You know, usually we sing it, but today we're going to just play it. Okay? I'll explain to you what happens. Over here, you will note there are three circles. Count them. One, two, three. Got that? And over here, you will see that there are three squares and one circle. Count the squares. One, two, three. Count the circle. One. Okay? Now then, the object of the game is to think about which of these things over here belongs over here with these three things. Got that? Note these three things here, you see? And look at these over here and see if you can tell which of these things here belongs over here with these three things. All right? I'll give you a hint. These three things over here are round. Okay?
Ooh. Circles.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, boy.
What are you going to do? Abbott. We're trying to play a game here.
That's terrible. Shh.
Oh, but listen. You can't just...
Yuck. Yuck.
You can't just
circles
come in here and take a...
Shh. 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 Yuck. Your circles are terrible. Yuck.
But we're trying to play a game. And you can't just come and take a bite out of all three of these circles over here. Let's see. No, let's play. Go back to the game anyhow. Now, this thing here doesn't have a bite taken out of it. And how can it belong with these things over here, which all have bites taken out of it? And this one here doesn't even have a bite taken out of it. Let's see. An idea. Hey, monster! Monster! Hey, monster! Monster!
What?
Listen, I couldn't help noticing how you happen to like taking bites out of these circles. And so I just thought, I got a nice circle here, and I was just wondering, how would you like to, taking a bite out of it?
No thanks.
No thanks?
No thanks. Those circles of yours are yucky. They're terrible. They taste crummy. Yuck.
Yeah, but, I guess there's only one thing to do now. Here goes. Yeah. Hey. Oh, that tastes pretty good. Hey, monster!
What?
Hey, this is delicious.
That's good?
Yeah.
The circle's good?
It needs a little bit of salt, but it's great.
I got some salt down here.
Oh, boy.
Can I try it?
Sure, have a bite.
Okay.
That's really beautiful. Isn't that nice?
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, wow,
that circle's delicious.
Wow.
Oh, I'll try a square over here, okay?
Yeah, how's the square?
Oh, the square is great.
Is it?
Oh, no.
Esta es la letra T, la más importante letra del alfabeto, porque T es para tigre, y yo soy un tigre. T es para tomate, taxi y toro. T es para teléfono y televisión. T es para... T es para tiburón, tonto, y tormenta. Al terrible tiburón le gustan los tigres.
And here come those crazy alphabet dancers, and they are dancing around in a crazy way. Tumbling around, ooh, another tumble. What are they going to do? They have just formed the letter T.
Okay, lay any word beginning with R on me, and I'll show you some magic stuff.
Okay, rabbit.
Rabbit. Keep it coming.
Rocking. Rock.
Not bad, huh?
Radio. Rope.
Anything beginning with R.
Rat.
Keep it coming.
Rip. Rain.
You better get under this umbrella, kid.
Okay, I'm ready. Rain.
You're wet.
A poem by Big Bird. I have a bandage on my beak, as you can plainly see, because I thought it might be fun to be somebody else than me. It seemed to me a woodpecker would be lots of fun to try, so I banged my nose on a tree all day. And now I want to cry. The end. Oh boy, that's smart.
Knock, knock. Who's there? It's a woodpecker.
We take you now to the secret forest hideout of the famous outlaw Robin Hood and his merry men.
Getting closer. I almost hit the tree that time. Yea, verily, I am indeed Robin Hood, and today I'm out here to get some more merry men. And there are a bunch of men out there waiting for the job, and So, send in the first merry man. Pardon me, sir, but merry means happy, and to be one of Robin Hood's merry men, you must be happy.
Happy? Happy? What have I got to be happy about? On the way over here, I tripped on a log, and my jelly sandwich fell into the river, and I think I'm getting a cold out here in the forest. Happy? I'm miserable.
Yeah, well, I don't think you're happy enough to be a merry man. So, thank you very much for coming by.
Don't call us. We'll call you. Well, I've heard that before.
Right. Okay. All right. Let's see who's next. Next. Send in the next applicant.
Oh, yeah? Well, that goes double for you.
Listen, are you here to be one of Robin Hood's merry men?
Oh, yeah? Well, let me tell you about that. I had to hike all the way out here to this woods, then I'm no place to sit down, I get my tunic all wet, I'll probably catch a cold, and I'm not very happy with this whole scene.
Well, you don't seem to be a very happy man.
You bet your bow I'm not happy,
and
bub.
And you have to be happy to be a merry man.
Oh,
instead,
yeah?
I think you're mad.
Well,
thank you very much for coming by, but I don't think it'll work out.
After I come all the way out here, you'll hear from my lawyer in the morning. Anyway, I don't need your crummy job.
I do hope we have a merry man out there waiting for the job. Next, send in the next man. At last, we have a merry man. Listen, you're hired.
Hey, did you hear the one about the duke who married the rabbit?
No, but...
They lived happily ever after. Happily,
yeah.
Get it? Rabbit? Hop?
Sure, but... listen, sir.
I wanted to be a baker, but I couldn't raise the dough. Raise dough money? Get it?
I can't believe my ears.
I can't believe them either.
On the other hand,
I wanted to be a doctor, but I didn't have the patience.
Listen,
but seriously, now take my wife, please.
Take my wife, please. Listen, I don't think you'll do. You're fired. You're fired. You're not a merry man. Listen, could it be Robin Hood and his sad men? How about Robin Hood and his angry men, huh?
Hey, why'd the chicken cross the moat? Tell me that, huh?
¿Qué es eso?
Una línea.
Una línea que va para arriba y para abajo.
No es más que eso.
Ahora es una línea con un triángulo.
Una bandera.
Y ahora es una línea con dos triángulos.
Ya sé, es un paraguas.
No.
Me equivoqué.
¿Tres triángulos?
¿Qué es eso?
Ahora son cuatro triángulos.
¡Es una cometa! ¿De veras? ¿Es lo que es?
¡Miren, miren lo que le está pasando!
¿Se cayó?
¡Y se le cayó un pedazo! ¿Qué es esto?
¡Ya sé! ¡Es un pescado!
Aunque eso es lo que era.
David, I'm going to bring up a word, and you tell me what that word is. Here it is.
Day? Oh, danger.
Danger. Very good.
T. Top. Lily! T.
This is about a boy named Dan. He left home with his sister. Nan. They packed their things and away they ran. The food they had was in a can. They heated it up in a frying pan. The sun was bright, so they used a fan. It was almost dark when they met a man. He drove them home in a moving van.
Tea.
tunnel. Tea. Tunnel.
Much too big to fit in the squares.
Oh, how about playing one of your games, you know?
Oh, would you like to?
Sure.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Here, I'll move around here, and then we can play a game I know, and it's called Doing the Snuffleupagus. Would you like to do it with me?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Oh, you put your right foot out. Take it back, you put your right foot out, and then you take it back, you put your right foot out, and then you leave it there. You're doing the snuffleupagus. Put your snuffle up, and then you take it back, you put your snuffle up, and then you take it back, you put your snuffle up, and then you leave it there, and you're doing the snuffleupagus. Dance is very easy when you've mastered every trick. Oh, dancing's very easy. Simply follow me and one, two, three, kick. Put your left foot out, and then you take it back. You put your left foot out, and then you take it back. You put your left foot out, and then you leave it there. And you're doing the snuffleupagus. Doing the snuffleupagus. Did you like that game?
Yeah.
Oh, me too. I'm glad you like it, because I think it's extra special fun.
He's sitting on the train track. Look, here comes the train. Uh-oh, danger. Here comes the train. Get off the track. Oh, he can't see the train. Danger!
Hey, what is that over there? I think I shall go see. It is a sign. I will see what it says. It's a danger. D-A-N-G-E-R. Danger. Oh, boy. I wonder where danger is. Is danger over there? No, danger is not over here. Maybe over here. No, danger is not over there. Is danger up there? No. Is danger down there? No. Hey, wait, is danger over there? No, danger not over there. Oh, maybe danger back there. No, danger not back here either. Oh, what a silly sign. Look!
make a snowman. No matter how I try, there isn't any snow in June or in July. I have a pair of coal eyes and a button for his nose. I do not think a snowman needs any other clothes. I tried to make a snowman out of ordinary ice, but it wasn't like a snowman, and I had to do it twice. I have something for above him and something for beneath. I even have a toothpick, should he want to pick his teeth. I tried to make a snowman out of ordinary sand, but it wouldn't stick together, and I couldn't make it stand. So I've come to the conclusion, and I don't care if you know, that you cannot make a snowman if you haven't any snow.
Now the baby stomach, un círculo grandote.
No!
Un círculo.
No, no
triangle,
way, no
triangle,
way.
Redondo. No!
Not square.
See.
Aha! La cabeza.
La cabeza.
Chiquitita.
Al lado del
redondo.
Cuerpo.
No!
Al lado del cuerpo redonda.
Aquí.
Frog here, and today I'm going to talk about one of the most exciting, the most wonderful things in the entire world, because today I'm going to talk about frogs. Now, you can tell that I am a frog, you see, and when you, excuse me, Bob.
Hi, Kermit.
Listen, I'm trying to give a lecture here about frogs.
Okay? Yeah, I know, that's why I came, Kermit.
What do you mean, that's why you came?
Well, I brought along a little surprise for you, but I'll show it to you later. Go ahead. Don't let me interrupt you, okay?
Now, frogs, as you can tell by looking at me, are rather greenish in color, you see.
Mm-hmm.
And we have two bulgy but beautiful eyes. We have a handsome profile. And large, strong legs.
Hey, that's okay? Very, very good, Kermit.
Yeah.
Why don't we take a look at my surprise, which is a real frog now, and see if you're right, okay?
What?
A real frog.
Good heavens. What is that?
It's an American bullfrog, Kermit.
My goodness, I'm handsome than I realized.
Hey, let's see if you were right now on all those things you said about frogs. Mm. First of all, you said they were green in color, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is kind of a nice green frog with a little few brown spots on him. Mm-hmm. And you said he had two large, beautiful, bulgy eyes, right?
Yeah, they're bulgy anyhow.
Mm-hmm. And legs, you said he had two powerful legs in the back?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they certainly are powerful.
And he's got a face that would stop a clock.
Hey, why don't you tell everybody where frogs live?
Okay, well, frogs live in apartment houses with furniture and television sets, and we sometimes
Kermit, I know you might live in a place like that, but most frogs don't live in apartments in the city.
Well, where do most frogs live?
Well, frogs like this like to live in ponds, riverbanks, swamps, maybe. Mud holes. You know, places like that.
Mud holes? Why, yeah. That's terrible. If you lived in a mud hole, your floor would get filthy.
Kermit, frogs like this don't ever have floors. They're just nice little animals that like to live along the water, that's all. Hey, why don't you tell everybody what... I'll tell them what frogs like to eat, okay?
Fried chicken and pizza. And frogs like me like to eat pancakes, and it's hard to beat French fries and hot dogs.
No, Kermit. No way. I know you love all those things, Kermit, but frogs like this don't eat that sort of thing. You see, they like flies, worms.
Flies? Worms?
Spiders.
Spiders?
Yeah, spiders. Oh, they love spiders, especially spiders. They love those. Kermit. Kermit, are you all right, old boy? What's wrong?
If you excuse me, Bob, I think I better go lie down for a while.
But, Kermit, aren't you going to finish your lecture?
Wait a minute. What was that?
Well, it's a frog. He's croaking.
Croaking?
You know, yeah, croaking. Croaking is the sound that frogs make, you know.
Is that... yeah? No kidding. Is that right? Oh, yeah, that's a good one, huh?
Kermit, what are you laughing at?
Oh, this frog, he's been telling jokes. Oh, yeah?
Telling jokes? Come on, Kermit. You don't mean to tell me that you can understand what this frog is saying.
Well, of course. I'm a frog, aren't I?
Well, yeah, I know, but you're not an ordinary kind of...
Oh, yeah? Sure. Mm-hmm. Well,
what
I
do you
did
know
too.
About that?
Mm-hmm.
I think Kermit made himself a new friend today.
Oh, yeah, sure. Mm-hmm.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
Hey, you want to count to 20? We'll take turns?
Yeah!
Oh, boy, okay. I go first and you go second, okay? And we keep on going like that, okay? Here we go. I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Oh, I am so proud of you.
Okay, now let me try this once more.
Okay.
All right.
Step on two.
On two.
No, you're on three.
Oh, that's three. There's
two. Okay, you got it. Step over and on go on three.
That's fine. Oh, that's three.
Oh, you got it now. Okay. Now step on 4 and 5 at the same time.
Okay.
Oh, you're doing it! Oh.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters R and T, and by the number 10. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.